Santa Clarita is not immune to what's going on in the market right now. We are seeing interest rates in the mid sixes, maybe the sevens, depending on the situation. And we are seeing VA a little bit lower than that, low sixes really right now. It depends on your situation as well. Veterans are always typically going to get the better rate. Wages are not going any much higher right now, which means affordability really, really sucks. And with that, we are seeing a lot of homes sitting on the market. And the thing is, when homes sit on the market, sellers are more willing to give you discounts on the purchase price, which is good for a buyer, yes, but if you can't afford it in the first place with a high interest rate, I mean, you kind of find the middle ground there. We're also seeing a lot of new construction contracts being canceled because a lot of buyers don't have the insight to lock in the rates initially. So with that, as the time comes to when they're closing, they can no longer afford the home. So what I'm seeing a lot of my clients do is take advantage of what's going on in the new construction market and jump in where a lot of people weren't able to execute on something. So they're seeing a lot of discounts with the purchase price on a new construction property. Granted, yes, they have the higher interest rate, but they're getting the lower purchase price. So with all these things going on, houses sitting on the market, people canceling new construction contracts, and us going into the winter months, we're definitely going to be seeing a higher correction in Santa Clarita. Now, I am a real estate agent in the Santa Clarita Valley. It's what I push a lot on, and I want to be realistic with you guys. Things are shifting. Things are shifting for sellers, and things are not looking the greatest for sellers. And typically, I am very bullish on Santa Clarita, and I'm going to give you a lot of the facts here today, but I want you guys to really buckle down and realize what is best for you and your family. Always do what's best for you and your family. The market could say a lot of things. The market say it's the worst market of all time, but if it's right for you, it's right for you. And if it's the best market of all time and it's wrong for you, just be conscious of that. Always protect yourself. Now, we had a total of 251 transactions completed in the month of September in the Santa Clarita Valley. The average sale price was $793,000. The average list price of those homes was at $819,000. Now, that's a little bit over a 3% difference from the list price to the actual sale price. Now, keep in mind that escrows typically take around 30 days. So we are seeing the repercussions of what happened the month before. These are the August numbers, essentially. The transactions started in August have been completed in September. So that's really what we're seeing. We are really going to see what happened in September in the month of October. So with that, on an average, sellers are losing $26,000 when they list their home improperly. In a buyer sense, what $26,000 really means in your monthly payment is just $164. So sellers are really losing out on a lot more money than the buyer is really gaining. So we are definitely seeing a big shift in what the market is giving us. Now, we're in a very particular market here in Santa Clarita, because not all the markets here in the Southland really have a lot of new construction going on. We have a lot of land out here, so we have a lot of opportunity. A lot of the areas here, like for LA County, for example, they have a finite amount of land. So any of the new construction is just like a renovation or a complete tear down to a different type of development. So there's not a lot of land to expand on. Santa Clarita does have that land to expand on. There's a lot of demand associated to Santa Clarita because of where it's positioned and just the lifestyle, everything that goes along to it. If you want to learn a little bit why people move to Santa Clarita, just click on this video here and it's going to show you everything basically. Now, with a typical seller, they're selling their own home, right? So they don't necessarily need to sell unless they're being forced to. With a home builder, they need to get rid of the inventory. So they're incentivized to give incentive to a buyer. So they're giving a lot of credits back. They're doing a lot of things to be able to entice a buyer to go in and purchase that inventory because they got to get rid of it. And we've been seeing a lot of cancellations. For example, I had this Marine Corps couple that were looking for a property out here in Santa Clarita, and they really weren't finding the right fit for them. So we ended up looking at new construction. And when we looked at the new construction, the builder was giving us, they were trying to sell us on everything that they could. And we ended up getting, I think, $30,000 less than the asking price of the property itself. And even at that, it appraised for more than what they purchased it at. So yes, we are seeing a correction in this Santa Clarita market, but it doesn't look completely bleak. And that's because we do have that new construction to really back us up and the high demand that goes along with Santa Clarita. Home prices are essentially just playing catch up with the normal wages that are typical in the Santa Clarita area. And the number one advice that I give to all of my clients when it comes down to it is to never stretch yourself thin. Always purchase when you're ready, when you're financially stable and ready to go on to that next step. Now, when I'm asked the question, and whether or not the Santa Clarita market will be crashing, it really forces me to dive into the data and figure out what's going on, go into different articles, and really do a lot of research. And with that, I rely on people who are way smarter than I am to give me all that data, because, you know, they're experts, so I'm going to go off of what they're saying. And a lot of the data is saying that nationwide, home prices are going to continue to appreciate. Now, I really want to emphasize that not all markets will appreciate. Some markets will go in a downturn and some markets will appreciate, as is with any market. So what I really wanted to do in order to do a little bit more research is compare this year's numbers to last year's numbers and see what, you know, what correlations we have there. What differences do we really have here? So as I said earlier, the average sales price for a home in Santa Clarita in the month of September was $793,000. In 2021, that number was $757,000. Now, yes, it is an increase. It's not a crazy increase, but an increase nonetheless. Now, these ebbs and flows that we see in the real estate market are very typical. But the thing that's not typical is the timeline. We usually see this timeline expanded out exponentially. So with that, year over year, you have increased in your equity. The thing is, month to month, you have not. And that's really the most interesting part of what's going on right now. Now, we saw a crazy spike in housing prices in the last 3 years. For example, in 2019, the average sales price in Santa Clarita was in the 500s. So with that, we've had a lot of equity growth. There's a lot of people interested in coming into the Santa Clarita Valley. So if you're a seller, you definitely have your equity still. And if you're a buyer, only an opportunity to go into a lower price now. Now, I don't see housing prices going back to what it was in 2019. Housing is too valuable now. Now, there are a ton of tools out there to help you figure out what's best for you and your family, whether or not Santa Clarita is the right area for you, what you can afford, and what you can sell your house for, things like that. I have links down below that can help you out. If you have any questions, all my contact information is down below.